hop into the main presentation. So I've actually been really looking forward to bringing Steve on to present to this group. Steve joined B2B Sunshine Coast earlier this year. We've been catching up quite a lot, talking about what the opportunity is for the LinkedIn guests and our members. And one of the big challenges when using any kind of platform like LinkedIn is the words. Like, how do we find the right words to craft our, whether it's our LinkedIn profile, whether it's our post, the follow-up direct message, the email? All of us in this room are writers. All of us are actively writing in our business. But no one often taught us, right? If we think about back to English school, no one, or back in English in high school, no one was really teaching us how to write for business, how to write to persuade, how to write to let people know what we're all about. So I'm really looking forward to for this session to help us all kind of get a better sense on how do we become just better writers. Whether you're writing it yourself or your staff members or using ChatGPT, having the ability to assess and review and understand what works and what doesn't is very, very powerful. And you'll find this session, you know, will deliver on that. So the influential marketer himself, Steve Plummer. And hopefully, if you haven't already, make sure by the end of the night you're picking up one of these books. I did promise Steve I was going to read it. I didn't. I'm so sorry. But I have scanned it. That's all I've done. And I did want to say it now so he didn't ask me, because I know he was tempted to go, Luke, did you? I was like, I'll admit it up front that I haven't had a chance. But it is...
Because last time I said, you've read it, Luke, haven't you? And no.
It was awkward. It was a little awkward. So I'll just admit it up front. I will. And one of the things that's really impressive about this book is it's designed as like a day-to-day guide. So each day you can pick up one page and do an activity. And what I really appreciated too, it is Steve's one of our most active members on the B2B Sunshine Coast website. He's actually been sharing tidbits from the book and posting it on our website so we can then reshare it through our network. And I the views that you got that you've been getting throughout through the B2B website and newsletter is the largest of any of our members. So just engaging with that content has really helped. So again, like a really good indicator of I think we've got the right person to speak tonight. So let me get this right in terms of the introduction for Steve. So Steve is a direct response marketing strategist and copywriter. And for the past 10 years, he's helped hundreds of business owners and corporates to create and deploy bespoke marketing campaigns. In the last 12 months alone, the Symmetry Marketing team has done the following, and this is pretty impressive stats. Created a campaign for an ASX-listed company that returned $14.9 million in new tenders. Taken a startup in the renewable energy field to a first sale of $150,000. And helped an IT consultancy grow from 3 to 12 staff and 3x their client base. So again, the power of just the words, right, with a little bit of strategy. So I think that's enough of an intro. What do you reckon, Steve? I think I got you. Cool. Give him a round of applause.
Thanks, everyone. All right, I'm starting with a video. Fingers crossed, everyone, technology works. Do I have to click it again? What did you do to my scene?
I wrote the same, but in different words.
Excellent. you might want to write that down. Change your words, change your world. Because as that little sign showed, that just a small tweak made all the difference. The other one you might want to write down is this one. Words are spells. And what I mean by that is the words you say to yourself, the words you say to your team, the words you say to your customers, we are actually creating and spelling, if you like, our future. That went woo-woo really quick, I know, but words are spells. And so I want to start there with that as a backdrop for what we're about to look at tonight. So when you see this slide come up, that means that you've got to get to work. So part of the networking, the interaction, there'll be some little tasks for you to do. And it helps, I think, expand your thinking and your network if you, on your table, you are working with someone you probably don't know. That would be a better thing. The other thing is when you do that, you'll be getting to work. And then when you see me raise my hand, that's your signal to come back in so we can move on. Everyone cool with that? Okay, here's the first thing. Do a 20-second intro. So pick someone you don't know on your table, next to you across the table, 20-second intro, your name, where you live, your business, and what you want to get out of tonight, and then obviously swap over with someone you don't know. Go. All right, folks, if we could focus back in, please. Radar. All righty. Hopefully you now know someone more than you did a few seconds ago. So you've grabbed your work buddy. I want you to work with them again. There are two photos there that are exactly the same. The one on the right has four differences. So with your work buddy you just introduced yourself to, find the four differences. You've got 30 seconds. Go. Who's got four? Excellent. Two or three people. Five more seconds. Five more. Three, two, one. Who else has got four? A couple more people. Okay, here we go. There was a cloud missing. There was a steeple on the clock and the number on the bus. Okay. Who can see them now? You can see them now? Okay. You might be thinking, hang on, this is about words and stuff. Why is this guy showing me pictures and asking me to spot the difference? Because here's the thing. I could have put that picture up on the slide there without saying anything to you, and you probably wouldn't have seen those differences. Yet when I asked you to look at something different or look at it in a different way, you were able to see many of those differences. True? Okay, and that's the secret to writing great sales copy for your business. It just looks like words to an outsider, but when you have information about looking at it in a different way, a whole new world opens up. And when you understand that coding, if you like, then that will change the way you look at your business, the way you market your business, and the results you get in your business. So who's glad they came? Alrighty, cool. I just want to acknowledge everyone too. I mean, there's many things you could be doing tonight. You could be in the bar. You could be at home watching TV. You could be scrolling through social media, but you chose to be here. So, kudos to you for investing in yourself. That's great. All right, so everyone's heard of the Matrix, right? We all know about that. You know, the red pill, blue pill. I can never remember which one it is, but, you know, when he takes one of those colored pills, the whole world changes. And that's the red pill, is it? Okay, so tonight I'm actually giving you the red pill. After tonight, you will not look at your words or your competitors' words for that matter the same way ever again. Words are spells. Words can change your world. So let's dive in. All right, I did mention a pill, but also tonight is not a magic pill. If anyone finds the magic pill, please give it to me. I've never found it in my life, so It's not a magic pill. However, what I'm showing you tonight can help you move the needle incrementally in your business in terms of conversions, reach, and all those sorts of things. All right. Generally, what I find when working with people, whether you know they're just starting out or they're experienced in business, is, and they're trying to write their own copy, is three particular problems, right? Number one is they don't know where to start. Number two is they can get lost halfway through. Who hasn't gone to start writing and go, you had all the, oh God, it was so good. You get halfway through and you go, who's ever had that happen to them? Yeah. All right. So there is a solution for that. And then the third one, you get to the end of it, right? And you actually don't know if it's any good or not. And it's this last one that really affects your confidence. And when you don't go to your market with confidence in what you do, I could get a bit more woo-woo and say words have vibrations, but when you go into to your market in an unconfident or a shaky state, people pick up on that. All right, so we'll solve some of those things. We'll solve all three of those things tonight. Okay, a little bit about me. I have been a copywriter for and a marketing strategist for about 14 years. Words, not numbers, are my thing. So the last time I, when I started was 2009. That's me in about 2014. I spent the first 20 years of my professional life as a as a high school teacher, head of department, and eventually deputy principal. It was a Wednesday. It was one of the coldest days that we've ever had on the Sunshine Coast, and I was able to get away from school for a couple of hours to come and join my boys in one of those kindy tour things that you know that they do. I'm smiling, but my eyes are showing a fair bit of pain. It was a life that I didn't really like. I was leaving home with four little kids. I was leaving home at 5:30 or 6 in the morning, getting home after 6, earning, I don't know, back then it was probably about, $85,000 or $90,000, which was reasonable money. But when you've got four kids and a mortgage, things get tight. So that was kind of where I started in life. I mean, it's okay. We all turned out okay. That's them now. They've grown up. But that was the sort of the start for me. I knew I was unhappy and I knew I wanted to change things. And the other thing that I was doing, I also was a freelance journalist while I was teaching. And you can see there the byline from one of the stories on a boxer from Tasmania by the name of Daniel Gill. You may or may not have heard of him. He became a world champion. Before that article that I wrote appeared, he had no ring name. After that article appeared, he was the real deal, Daniel Gill. And he went on to claim a world title and was, you know, one of Australia's top boxers there for a while. So even back then, I kind of had an understanding of the importance of words, because it was kind of like, even though it was inadvertent, it kind of like completed him. I won't say I made him a world champion, but it kind of, oh, it's recorded. But, you know, it kind of completed him in that way. The other thing, I've also been a boxing ring announcer just for interest's sake, you know, and fighting out of the red corner, weighing, fighting fit, 85.3 kilograms. I just thought it was a bit amusing, but that's real, right? Let's get back on track. Change your words, change your world. So that's literally true for me. I'm living proof of that. And everything that I show you tonight, I either use with myself or with my clients. So there's nothing that is theory here. It is all practical stuff. So that was about 2006, I think. I went to Sydney for an event just on a whim in the encouragement of my wife, Jenny. And at that event, and this was the time when I was in pain, but at that event, there was a guy sitting down the front room and he said, oh, look, I've got four kids. I work from home in my own hours and I earn six figures as a copywriter. And I went, I'm working my butt off as a deputy principal. I'm really unhappy. I'm not earning six figures. I hardly see my kids. I'm not working from home. And so I actually went and it's probably anti-stalking laws now, but he was good enough to help me and mentor me and help me to change careers. And that is me on the first day of being a professional writer, which was about 2009. And I think my face is very different there, at least my eyes are very different there. So words actually did change my life, and I've used them and got good enough at it to help other people to change their lives as well. These people, you may or may not know them, but I've traveled to the US quite a lot to learn my craft. That's Jay Abraham. I've met Dan Kennedy. I've met Greg Renker from, you know, the Pimple Cream Proactive, from Guthy Renker. Frank Kern, the late Joe Sugarman, and Russell Brunson from ClickFunnels. I've spoken on the same stage as him. So I've kind of, words changing my life has actually been real for me. And I have clients in many states around Australia. My favourite clients are Ali and Danny from South Australia. They sell big farm sheds into the rural community. And I've been working with them for about 5 years. And I'll just show you a couple of examples, because it's easy enough to say things, but to see some examples. 2 years ago, the industry went through this big growth period, but there are all these steel price rises. The good thing about steel price rises is that they always sold a lot of sheds. The problem from a marketing point of view, how do you make the same thing, a steel price rise, new and interesting each time? So that was one of the challenges. And so just month after month, I came up with different ideas to help them, do really, really well. And 2 years ago, they had a record month in their business, and the campaign on the right was the vehicle that gave them their record campaign. And I'll show you shortly one of the reasons, or some of the reasons, why that did really, really well. And like I said, everything I'm sharing with you tonight, I use myself, or I use for other people's businesses. That was from the corporate space. The 600% ROI that Luke mentioned. And what I've done is all of the stuff that I've learned over the last, well, since 2009, I've actually packaged it into a book, the one that Luke hasn't read. And it doesn't mean that you have to be a corporate client to read it and to get benefit. For example, Nat lives at Tawantin. I think she runs a car detailing business with her family. And she opened page 38, tried one of those subject lines I suggested there, and got a 51.9% open rate for an email, which led to a sale or two. So the stuff works. It still works. And who'd like to know more about how to make it work for you? All right, let's dive in. Oh, stick around to the end. I do have a thank you gift for you. If you're busy, time poor, who would like more time in their life? Why? Yeah, okay. I've got a little gift for you. I didn't create it, but I'm happy to share it with you. All right, so the 5 ways to improve your messaging overnight, even if you hated English at school. Are we ready? Pen and paper ready to go? Ready to get to work? Yes? All right, here we go. Number one, you improve your messaging overnight if you use a formula. A formula. And I'll show you an example of that. Firstly, though, I love the book Thinking Fast and Slow by Daniel Kahneman, a Nobel Prize winner. He says to get people to say yes, there's this thing that goes, so cognition is the workings of the brain, right? How the brain thinks. And he says that there's two states that we're in. There's either cognitive ease or cognitive difficulty. And basically he says that when there is cognitive difficulty, acceptance is low. What he's saying is that people are confused when it's cognitively difficult. And this is the key thing. You might want to write this one down as well. Confused people do nothing. And think about it yourself. You know, if you go, oh, will I, won't I, oh, I don't know, I'll come back to it. You never do. Who does that? Yeah, all of us. So confused people do nothing. And so everything that you do from a marketing perspective, from a words perspective, needs to be from that cognitive ease point of view. If you make it cognitively easy for them, you up your chances of a yes and of success. All right, so here's the thing, right? Copywriting is about structure. It's not about prose. So prose is like the way words go together. You know, I could use the word dialogue there or discourse, but copywriting is about structure, not about prose. And so Luke mentioned it, but I don't know, 70% of the stuff you learned at school, if you're writing for your business, you can generally chuck out. Who's happy to hear that? Yeah, most people are, right? Because, oh, I wasn't very good at writing. You don't have to worry about that. You just have to be good at the structure. Why? Because the structure makes it cognitively easy for someone to say yes. So that's what I was talking about at the start for the red pill, blue pill thing, right? When you see what's going on behind the scenes, then you know what to do. All right. I'd just like you to have a quick read through that just yourself. Read fairly smooth, fairly quick. Some cognitive ease there. It's made up, by the way, it's just an example. But the reason that there is cognitive ease there is because that follows a structure. The structure that I'm about to show you has resulted, I didn't make it up, I just use it in just about everything that I do, but it's resulted in, I don't know, tens of millions, billions of dollars in sales around the world over the last 40, 50, 60 years, whenever the first person who created it. Would you like to know what that is? Okay. So cognitive ease, it's the PASPA formula. PASPA is pretty simple. It stands for identify a problem, aggravate that problem, solve the problem for them, prove the solution works, and then ask them for action. In other words, tell them how to get it. This one tip will change your business and change your world because it gives cognitive ease. That's a buying formula, which is cognitive ease. It takes us from pain to pleasure. It solves a problem. That is the red pill. Often, if you don't follow that structure, there's that word again, structure, then people get confused. And more likely, as the writer of it, you probably get confused as well. All right, so let's see what that looks like. So where's the problem? Right, I mean, as I said, this is just an example. The cold call algorithm is just nonsense, but I just made it up to show you. But here's the problem, right? Agents everywhere agree, the number one frustration. Now, if you're a real estate agent, that's going to get your attention, right? Because that's one of your problems. Next thing is we aggravate the problem. Well, why is that a problem? That gets people annoyed, but in a good way, because it gets them to think about their issues, the issues that they want solutions to. So what do? We offer them a solution. Then we make sure that it's proven. And then we tell them what to do. I'll talk about it a little bit more later on, but this one here is one of the key things that will change everything in your writing. You might want to write this down. People don't like walking into a dark room. So you actually need to tell them what to do and what's going to happen. So it's about turning the light on for them. So red pill, turn the light on for them. Well, it seems pretty simple enough. Yeah? Who's glad they came? All right, let's see how well you can do. Here we go. There's the symbol. You've got, we'll say 5 minutes, maybe a little bit less. Identify the problem, aggravation, solution, and proof and call to action in that email. This is a real email, by the way. Go. Work with your partner. Okay. How do we go? Who thinks I nailed it? Who thinks they nailed it? Pretty good. All right. Here we go. There's the problem. There's the aggravation. It's not always in bullet points either. It's never not always that easy. Okay, it's just for illustration points. There's the solution. You've got to know what you're doing. There's the proof, as someone myself who's done it and taught others to do it. There's the action. Pretty easy, right? Problem, aggravation, solve, proof, call to action. If you follow that, your writing is going to be a hell of a lot more powerful. Just a quick admin thing too. I'm noticing a lot of people taking photos. Remember the days when you went to a seminar, you had to sign non-disclosures and no one was allowed taking. Now it's, take a photo if you like. In fact, we'll give you the slides. Don't worry about it. Luke's just told me you will have access to the slides on the B2B website. All right. So if you don't get something, you know, don't fret. All right. So who likes that? Useful? Okay. Who's glad they came? Great. All right. Here we go. So, three main reasons people get blocked when they go to write for their business. We pretty much sorted that out, right? Because now you know where to start. Identify a problem. Aggravate the problem. If you get lost halfway through, there's an anchor point there. Oh, have I aggravated enough? Have I put any proof in? What's left is to get some confidence about whether it's any good or not what you write. All right, so number two, improve your messaging overnight. Use key trigger words. All right, so remember, confused people do nothing. Remember, cognitive ease is what we want. Okay, these words here, these come from, and this was done in about the late 1990s, I believe, the top 100 headline power words or trigger words. So someone did a study of newspaper advertisements in the United States that had the best results over a long period of time. And they counted the number of trigger words in those headlines and compiled that in a list. Here's the list. When I first started writing, I used to put that next to my computer. Obviously, the two most powerful words in any headline are you and your. And that's one of the reasons why we always should be writing from the point of view of what's in it for me being your buyer, not you, the business owner. If you can even flip that thing around, that's another big one. So you, your, how, new, who, money, now, people, want, why. I don't think I've written a headline, maybe I've written one or two, but that don't have at least two of those words in a headline. Why? Cognitive ease. Why? Because they're proven trigger words. So when you understand copywriting, you'll understand that things are not done by accident. Okay, you will look at things differently. I'll give you an example. There's the title for tonight's presentation. What do you see in there? You, your, no accident. Like I said, everything that I'm teaching you tonight, I use myself. Here's another example. Here's another example. All right, this is your work time again with your work buddy. You've got maybe two or three minutes. No, we'll make it 3 or 4 minutes. So the website to buy the book, The Influential Marketer, if you don't pick one up here, is theinfluentialmarketer.org, right? So I've just done a screen capture here of the hero section, the top third of it, all right? And there's the trigger words. With your partner, have a quick discussion. How many of those trigger words do you see in that hero section of my website? Go. People, all right, let's have a look. Let's see how well you did. Here we go. New, who, want, your, new, you, how. Who got all those okay? Yeah. Your, anyone see over there, your? Now, if you're really good, really hardcore at copywriting and marketing, you would have also, secrets is a really powerful word as well. And you would have also gone, profits, that's like money, right? So especially if it's a B2B thing, right? What do businesses want? I want more profit. So it's another one of those trigger words. And if you were really, really, really good, you would have also said, look, at the buttons have got what? Now, like I said, there are no accidents. Are you seeing the patterns? Now that you've taken the red pill, are you seeing the difference? Very, very different, right? All right, I wrote this in just to show you that, you know, this has longevity. I wrote this in about 2015, maybe 14. It was a landing page for a webinar, which was the start of a big campaign to sell property at Robina down the Gold Coast. And they, at the end of the campaign, they sold all the properties they had. I don't know, maybe $4 or $5 million in sales. But I just want you to, again, scan both the bullets on the right-hand side and the hero section on the left-hand side and just, again, identify where those words are, those trigger words are. Just about 30 seconds or so. All right, let's just start down the bottom. Free. Your, you've your, so same thing, right? Yourself even. If you look at the bullets, there's, you know, if you start at the top there, it gives you, you know, why people. Nothing is there by accident. All of those trigger words are incorporated in. Even the button, right? Register now. You know, most investors won't get this chance. A deal 16 months in the making is now available. When you use words like now, it makes it urgent, it makes it immediate. That makes it cognitively easy for your reader. All right, so there is never anything by accident, anything that I write. And after tonight, because you've been given the red pill, there won't be anything by accident that you write either. We've seen the patterns. We entered the matrix. Alrighty. This did relatively well for the shed people in South Australia. Just even look at, you know, are you and your district considered a respected farm? First line, you and your are there twice. Now understand too, there's a fair bit of massaging that goes into it. So I mean, the writing that I do, it flows, right? It can't be stilted, but it flows. And that's that cognitive ease thing as well. Over here, this was the one that was their record month from memory. Again, there are no accidents. You know, when you order, see how you too, you know, when you order, whoops, you know, there are no accidents. Doesn't matter what media it is. This is media agnostic, whether it's LinkedIn or Facebook, direct mail, direct mail. Email. Okay, so no accidents. All right, here we go. Number three, you've got to get them at hello. Remember, you know, Jerry Maguire? Remember the movie? Who remembers that? Tom Cruise, Renee Zellweger. Okay, there was a scene towards the end when, and you might remember this, Renee's, I think it was her sister, her older sister, and some other of her friends that were sitting around in the lounge room having a bitch session. Remember that? Men are this, men are that. I hate men cunts. Remember that? That scene, right? In walks Tom Cruise, right? And they all stop. Look, it's one of those awkward movie moments. Renee was in the kitchen getting tea or coffee or whatever, comes out. And this was, you know, Tom Cruise was great. You know, you complete me. And, you know, well, remember that? Who remembers that? Really corny, but it was fun. What does she do? She says, stop. You had me at hello. You've got to get them at hello with your headline. If you don't get them at hello, it's over. Nothing else matters. So unless you grab people with a great subject line or a great headline, they will not read on, or a great first line of copy. They will not read on and it's over. Remember, Renee, you had me at hello. So if you don't get them there, it's over. All right. Who would like my general guidelines for headlines, headline lengths? Yeah. All right. So headlines generally. Now, remember, with everything in marketing, right, there are no absolutes. Absolutely no absolutes. Okay. I can give you, I'm absolute about that. It's absolutely true. So there are no absolutes in marketing. These are the guidelines I use. But you saw respected farmer. It was two words. It's outside the guideline. But generally 8 to 10 words for a headline. Sorry, 8 to 12 words for a headline. There's lots of references to headlines in the influential marketer. Who's got a copy of the influential marketer, by the way? Yeah, quite a few people. Excellent. Luke, have you read yours? Yeah, Luke's got his hand up. Put your hand down, Luke. Excellent. Okay, subject lines for emails, 3 to 5 words. Sometimes I just use one word. Sometimes it might be a little bit longer. Again, multiple references in the influential marketer, including Nat's, page 38 that was. I can't remember which subject line I suggested she use, but it worked for her. And then the first line of copy, I generally make 5 to 7 words long. Why? Because I want them to get into the message really, really quickly. If they're not into the message quickly, then that's a form of not getting them at all. All right. So you want to know if your headline's any good? Okay, so this is the confidence thing. So I'll give you two methods. One is an old school method. The other one's a more modern one that uses algorithms and stuff like that. So number one, the old school test for any headline. If it was just like the old classified ads in the newspaper. Remember newspapers? Remember classified ads? If it was just your headline and a phone number, would the phone ring? Here's what I mean, and Gavin, we're going to use your example from last, if that's all right. So the headline, I might even change the name a little bit to, you know, yeah, anyway. So the headline for the website was Welcome to East Coast Labor Hire. Now I want to know if that's any good. If I just put a phone number underneath it, who's inspired to pick up the phone by that? Not really, hey. What if you massaged it a bit and changed it around? So just on the fly, I created that. Here's the fastest, easiest way to get qualified and gain full-time employment. Has that one got a chance of being acted upon? Okay, see the difference? Just a quick mental test. Put a phone number at the bottom of it. Know if you're going to get them at hello or not. Simple little tip. See, there's no absolutes. Yeah, I could, but I mean, there's still actually, let's move on. I said it was on the fly, but you're right. You know, look, and here's the thing, right? I will show you a quote really soon. When I write headlines, I'm writing 10, 20, 30, 40 even to pick out the best one. That was done quick on the fly. I'd probably kind of massage that a bit more. You know, it could be a who else wants, you know, to gain qualified employment or something like that. I'd play around with those. All right, so yeah, the old school test. All right, the modern test. I didn't create this piece of software, but on the website of the influential marketer, there's a little tab with resources. It's free access to resources. You've just got to put your email in there. I've got two resources in there that test. One tests the emotional value of a headline. The other one tests the impact of a headline. So it's created by SharePoint, I believe. So it's the software looks like this. Again, this is just a screen capture. What you do is you type your headline in there when you do that. So there's the headline from my book, right? New book reveals the secrets to greater influence and profits. Then what it does, it uses its algorithm and it gives you three different scores. So the first one is a headline strength score. When it's in the green, obviously, there's a chance that's going to be a good headline. What I like about this too, it gives you some other suggestions to think about. So this is, I've been using this since about 2016, this thing. It's kind of, a pre-AI type thing. The other score it gives you is an engagement score and an impression score. Now, they're average and they're also reflexive. In other words, when one's high, the other one is often low. And sometimes they're both just ordinary. But I'm quite anal with this sort of thing. So I wanted to also, I'm happy with the headline because it scored high, but I thought I want to put my subheads there to see if they make any difference as well. So I just ran it again, entered my sub headline, you know, this easy to consume lesson per page, per day Bible, etc. 78 and 67 and 85. So I had three good green high numbers there. So that was an indication to me that that headline had a really good chance of working. Okay, it's free. You don't need to, you know, to pay anything to use it, but I use it in every single promotion that I use. Who likes that one? Pretty cool, huh? All right, so grab your buddy really quickly. You've got, well, we'll make it 3 minutes. Here's what I want you to do. Okay, can you, on your phone, bring up your website's current headline? And what I would like you to do, swap your phones and then do two things. Does your website's current headline pass the phone ring test? And are there some other trigger words you could put in there? You might go, oh God, this is really uncomfortable. But getting advice and feedback now is way better than getting crickets from your market. All right, 2 minutes, go. All righty, make sure that you don't look for absolutes right now. Now is just a start, and it'll give you some pointers to go and make some improvements to your website, your top third of your website, right? Don't expect absolutes. Okay, let's keep going. Now, the fourth way to improve your messaging is to tell them what to do. Single-handedly, this is the single biggest mistake I see in most copy that I critique. We are not clear enough about our calls to action, and that's universal. Stuff I critique from really experienced business owners and marketers. Like I said, people don't like walking into a dark room and they won't. So take away the confusion by telling them what to do really, really clearly. Okay, so here are the top five mistakes that I see that everyone assumes that people will know what to do. If they see a button there, they will automatically click on it. No, tell them they've got to click on it. Tell them exactly what to do. It's so important, you know, and people then go, well, you know, you don't understand, my market's too sophisticated for that. No, they're not. They're distracted and they're busy and they need to be told what to do. That's another one. If you just make that one change, be clearer, telling them what to do, that will change things. Number two, too few reminders. They won't remember. You know, they won't. They will not remember. Tell them two or three or four times or more. Unclear instruction. Remember, confused people do nothing. Make it simple and clear. Number four, I don't want to be salesy. Well, don't tell them what to do and don't make any sales. Okay, you really have to be clear and explicit. And number five, not understanding their fear. Fear comes up when you don't know what's going to happen. So tell them what's going to happen. Tell them what to do and tell them what's going to happen. You know, when you click the button below, you'll be taken to the registration page where you'll be asked to enter your details. From there, da-da-da-da-da. Turn the light on for them. Tell them what's going to happen to them. Cognitive ease, right? That's what we want. Okay, quick examples. So this is from that record campaign for the Shed Company. All right, so look at all the number of times that I tell them what to do. I make sure there's at least two calls to action on every page there. Here's the emails that went with that. Two calls to action. Really important that you do. All right, here's from my website. There's an order now or a buy now button 8 times on the website. You might go, isn't that excessive? Well, I don't know when people are going to buy. It might be a testimonial. It might be a picture. It might be some nice words. It might be just one thing. I don't know when. So I want to make it as easy as possible. Tell them what to do. Give them multiple opportunities to do it. Okay, here we go. Improve your messaging overnight, the speed of the read. Your message has to get read fast. People are so busy, distracted, et cetera, today. We don't want to read the stuff that's put in front of us, so it must read fast. Who would like to know how to read, make their copy read fast? It's really, really easy. Here's the thing, though. I love this quote from Hemingway. The first draft of anything is shit. Right, so if the great man can do that, can say that, it's a really good lesson for business owners as well. Here's what happens. Often people edit as they go. Who does that? Come on, there's lots of anal people here. Oh, I don't like that sentence. 3 hours later, it's a perfect sentence, but you haven't done anything, right? So when you write, write. When you edit, edit. Understand that the first draft you do, though, is shit, right? And you have to go back and massage it. Really, really important you understand that. Okay, the other thing is write with your eyeballs. Make it easy to read, not daunting. Here's two examples. It's the same script. The one on the right is far easier to read, less daunting. So you don't want chunky paragraphs. You don't want it to be hard for people to read. Space it out. Aid readability. It's easier and faster to read that. Next one, write to a 12-year-old or 12 or 13-year-old. Why? A year 8 student. That's the average reading age of the Australian population. Write to that level. Do you want to know how to do that? Okay. No, it's actually built into Word. So there is this thing called the Flesch Kincaid grade score. And it was done by, I think they might have been Harvard professors, Flesch and Kincaid. And they worked out based on complexity of sentences and word length, how easy or hard a sentence is to read. And when you, if you turn, I'll show you how to turn it on in Word, but when you do, you just click your normal editing, you know, your spelling and grammar check, it actually comes out down the bottom here with those two things. There are two important numbers here. You might want to write these down. So the reading ease, the Flesch reading ease, you want that 60 or higher. And then you want the grade level to be 8.5 or less. That's a tool I use all the time. Every single thing that I write, from a tiny email to, you know, a 10,000 word thing. 60 or higher and 8.5 or less. If you can achieve that, it's really, really easy for people to read. Notice this one is really good because it's 75.4. and 5.4. So that's going to be really easy to read. Okay, other things that I use the Hemingway app, I use Grammarly, I use Word Hippo. So there are other free online things you can use to, you know, help your copy be really easy to read. There are others, but they're the ones I use. All right, how you turn it on really quickly, you open a Word doc, you click File, you click Options, click Proofing. All you've got to do is make sure the readability statistics button is clicked, right? That's all it is. Then next time you go to do a spelling grammar check, it will tell you. There is a similar thing in Mac, but I'm a PC user, not a Mac, but you'll be able to find it. Okay, but it's very, very similar. Who likes that one? Yeah, it's really good, eh? You don't even have to do anything to know. Then you've got to go back and might have to go back and massage it. All right, so we covered the first two. I've given you several ways to know if it's any good. So we've covered those three things. The three things that stop people, we've covered tonight. Who's glad they came? All right, cool. Okay, so we've got 5 minutes left. I might come back to that one because I do want to leave you with this gift. Okay, The Busy Entrepreneur, it's also on page 90 of the book. I first heard this, I'm going to go woo-woo again, back here, about 2005. It's from the Abraham Hicks universe, if you're familiar with Abraham. I also heard it when I was at a conference in the US in 2014. Basically, if you are really busy, the start of any day, you do this. Take a blank piece of paper, rule a line down the middle, line at the top. On the left-hand side, you put things I will do today. Right-hand side, things I'd like the universe to do today. Now, if universe isn't your thing, God, Buddha, whatever it might be, higher self. And on the left-hand side, all you simply do is write your to-do list, the normal things that you would do. On the right-hand side, the things that you may not want to do, or the things that are hard, or the things you seem blocked in. I have no idea why this works, but every time I use it, 70% of the time of those difficult things on the right-hand side will either happen that day or the next day without me doing anything. That's unbelievable, I know. Try it for 2 weeks. It will change things. Why does it work? I don't know. It just does. Who's glad they came? Try it out. All right, really quickly, remember, words are spells, right? Words are spells. All right, so who would like some more support? I've got two options if you would like some more support from me. Obviously, the first one is the book, The Influential Marketer. It's a page per day. Okay, so it's easy to read. It's not sequential, so it's easy to read. Okay, they're $35. See Jenny down the back of the room before you go tonight. or you can buy them online, but then you're paying postage. All right, so $35. Now, the second thing I'd like to tell you about, for small businesses, I run what I call the Influential Marketer Success Lab. And that is a 13-week program where we meet once a week at noon, usually a Tuesday, and it's live open Q&A. So a little bit like we've done tonight, you get to ask me any question. Just say, what's this headline like? How can I improve that? I might do some critiquing. I definitely do direct teaching from the influential marketer like I've done tonight. Small group, goes for 13 weeks. It's a really simple call to action. Okay, there's an expression of interest and an info sheet. So when you scan the barcode or go to that URL, you enter your details and then you get access to the info sheet. Once you've read that, you'll know if it's right for you or your business. There's no hard sell, no fake scarcity, no run to the back of the room. It's simply, if you feel it's right for you, you will know that it's right, and there's instructions in there about what to do. All right, so there are your two options. By all means, grab a book if you want to. And if you want more support from me over the next 13 weeks, we start in a couple of weeks. There is only 8 places on it though. Make sure you scan that and get the information sheet. Now, when you scan that, by the way, that doesn't commit you to anything. Okay, it doesn't commit you to anything at all. All right, so I think that we're pretty much done there, Luke. So thanks everyone. If you want to email me, there's my email address, steve@symmetrymarketing.com.au. Thank you everyone. Hopefully the red pill is going to work for you.